the Federal Reserve illegal and central banks, and why I've been saying all along, you cannot bet against the Fed because the Fed will win. They are cheater, pumpkin eaters. And I can neither confirm nor deny that that young lady cheated on that man. And in post-editing, I just realized that he cheated on her. You sick man. We got a lot to talk about today. We got inflation, deflation, we got the Fed, we got all these crazy things going on. JCPenney is showing other retailers, hey guys, you need to slim down. And I think that slimming down probably goes for every American that's been locked home eating just about everything in the house. You're like, no, I'm fine. Oh yeah, okay, Charles, you go try on those bathing trunks from last summer. We're not talking about the stretchy waistbands. As you're sitting there looking in your mirror, your belly hanging over them, I look just fine. Welcome back to my channel, and if you like a channel that does not talk about politics, because every time I do, I get yelled at, consider subscribing. I make videos about how to make money, start businesses, make money, invest in the stock market news. And then sometimes I go out on a limb and talk about the Fed. Fingers crossed that my channel just doesn't all of a sudden just disappear someday. So how do you own the entire world? The answer to that is own assets. Now, I just want to show you a quick clip from Robert Kiyosaki, whether you love him or hate him. You guys need to think of it this way. With anything, I don't care if it's Donald, you take what is good and then you go, oh, I'm going to use that in my life. A lot of people give you good and bad. You look at that and you're like, I will take that. I mean, the Donald's amazing at negotiating skills. So take the negotiating skills. Robert is really good at acquiring assets and teaching you something like that. So let's look at this clip and then I'm going to show you what the Federal Reserve is doing.
Instead of living below my means, or what most people have as a J-O-B, a job, you can only work so hard. So my goal, my wife's goal every single year, is we increase our assets. So we buy more rental property, we invest in oil, gold, stocks that pay dividends and all this. So every year, our income or our cash flow keeps increasing. Every year, our goal is not to get a higher paying job. Our goal is to keep increasing our assets.
And right now, there is like a gold rush for central banks. It's like, oh, crisis. Let's just buy everything. But more importantly, let's buy every asset. So I'm putting this chart up just to show you. It's not just the good old US of A, it's everyone. And this isn't just from me. This is also from Jeffrey Gundlach, or as some of you would call him, Gunlatch. Fed's corporate bond buying program is illegal. But the Fed says, no, we're not actually operational. That actually reminds me when a government agency says, oh no, this program is just temporary. Please understand that means forever-ary. And here is the law from what the Fed, the guidelines that the Fed needs to do. Gundlach, I love this guy. Is squarely in the camp of Wall Street on parade, except that we will go one step further. The Federal Reserve Act is more than a charter. It has been codified into law. And there is nothing in that law that indicates the Fed is allowed to do more than make loans. And it's sad how I always get corrected in the comments section, but I don't have time to go over everything over and over. Yes, I understand. The Federal Reserve is legally obligated to only make loans. That's it. To loan deposits to the central banks. That's it. But as you can see here, they are obviously not going by that law any longer. I think the act came out, what was this, 1913? I could be off by a couple years. So now it looks like the complete game, the show, the 100-year show is starting to come to a close, where they are buying every asset under the sun. And then in the end, they are the buyers, the lenders, the owners of last resort. And this report just came out May 22nd. I just wanna show you total assets of major central banks. Do you see these? They're collecting assets like it's Christmas time, and especially right now. And these are central banks, not just in the United States, but this is also around the world. So when they see something like, oh, a calamity, or this is a virus and we need to stop it, so let's just buy everything. As you can see from the charts, there is nothing under the sun. Well, besides equities, and they're going after those too, even though they'll say, no, we'll just stick with bonds right now. And here's the Fed's balance sheet. We got Fed's assets. We have Fed's liabilities. We're up to $7 trillion. You want to know who is liable? It's not the Fed. That would be actually you. And here's U.S. Treasuries held by the Fed. And if that isn't a hockey stick, I don't know what is. And for those of you like, what's a U.S. Treasury? The banks like to use those. It's like cash. They don't really use cash. They use treasuries. That's where the big money comes in. The big, big treasuries. That's what they move. They look at treasuries as cash. So now look at that chart and go, boy, oh boy, that's a lot of cash that they're holding. And like what I said before, it's not just America. This is ECB. We're talking everyone is going, oh wait, it's like when the kid hits the pinata and all the candy goes flying and everyone and their mother, well, the mothers are like, no. And then everyone goes, oh, they can do it. I can do it. I'll grab it. Okay, everyone get it at one time. Buy all the assets humanly possible on Earth, quick. I would have to say that Powell has taken us where no man has gone before, nor woman. Janet, don't want to leave you out. The Fed goes all in with unlimited bond buying plans. The Federal Reserve will buy bonds as needed to calm the markets. You guys just relax, because our job is to calm the stock market. And we'll buy corporations too. We'll buy you too. And the stocks, wait till we take another swing and we start grabbing all the equities. And we'll just nice and neatly put them on our little balance sheet until we finally get to win that game of Monopoly. 100 years, just when you thought the game of Monopoly took a long time, took these cats over 100 years to win. And that's why I've been so bullish in securities. And before I even say the word security, it is not secure. Don't listen to anything out of my mouth. You'll lose all your money. I am not your accountant, not your broker. Go talk to your broker at Robinhood. Do they even have brokers over there? And shout out to one of my subscribers yesterday. I was able to go through comments. I just wasn't able to answer them. Guys, I'm getting a lot of comments and I really want to sit down, but it takes hours to talk back to you. But then I go, oh gosh, I have to script another video. So please have grace on me. I see your comments. I'm just not able to respond to all of them. And I actually have guilt from yesterday because I don't think I responded to anyone. But when it comes to the big industries, I am all steam ahead. If I think the Fed can put a nice cement floor under the bottom of it, I am going to take my said digits and invest that way. But this was actually one of the trades. Actually, he let all of you guys know in the comment section right here. And if for some reason you guys would like to learn about swing trading, not my course, friend's course, Charlie, he gives you guys 10% off. I will leave a link in the description. But take a look at this one. Again, one candle close above. You got momentum. Ooh, beautiful earnings call. That just put some rocket boosters on that. And you would have taken your stimulus check. What are we looking at? Woo, baby. 141% from that candle to that candle. But how do you know, Johnny Bravo, when to get out? When I get out is going to be different than when you get out. But some things that I look for, not always, and I have it all up on the screen, usually all the time, it's this. It's this, and it is this. That would be the 20, the MACD, and the RSI. When I start to see it die, I'm like, uh-oh, spaghetti-o. Probably good time to close my position and take my 141%. But now let's look at what was offered to all of us in the comments section yesterday and see what that trade would have made us. I mean, depending on if you want to just hold that thing and let it ride. Right now, you're looking at between 6 and 7% as of this morning. But you know what? I still see strength down there. You could keep that a-going. Or you could take, what, 20% off the table. Maybe 30% off the table. See, you don't want to just go all in, go all out, go in. I mean, that's just the part of trading. You do percentages. Johnny Bravo, what are some of the stocks that you trade? I get that asked a lot, too. Not all the times. These are some of my watch list. I do cryptocurrency also. That's a tough one to swing trade. I just want to let you know, because you can get stopped out so fast. These whales come in and wham, it's like up to 10, down to 6. You're like, what just happened? SPXL and SPXS, that's the S&P 500. So you can go one side, you can go to the other. Facebook, Amazon, Netflix, Google, DIA, that's the Dow Jones Industrial Average, Tesla, Bitcoin, gold. I do not like trading gold as the ETF. I actually like to own the real shiny stuff. And then we have Deutsche Bank. Love to use that one as an example. When grandma and grandpa tell you to make sure, kids, that you buy and hold, the stock market always goes up. Well, that just depends on what you're talking about. What stock market? What stonks? We don't know what you're talking about. Let me move this from the 1 hour, because grandpa says that, you know, banks will always be around, and you just basically went from buying and holding from the top all the way down to the bottom. Yeah, you only lost roughly 94% of all of your money. And if you want to lose a whole lot more, you just wait, kids, until there's negative interest rates. Boy, banks are going to be in a whole lot of trouble. But again, that would be a video for, that'd be three other videos. And this one should only take me about 30 seconds to get out of the way. Is, are we in inflation? Are we going into hyperinflation, deflation? We are in deflationary times. When you have a recession, it's deflationary. But wait, Johnny Bravo, my favorite YouTuber, says that it's, we're gonna be in hyperinflation and inflation, blah, 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 buy this, buy that. No, 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 no. If you were to take a look at these charts, look, here is, this is, oh, I guess I need to explain what this is. This is velocity of money. This is how $1 goes around and comes back. And right now, your dollar ain't moving, and it has not been moving since, right, you know, been slippery slope since 1997. So no matter how much the Fed prints, which the Fed doesn't print, yes, I know, they loan, it's the Treasury that prints, no matter how much they're printing, it's not moving around. You guys are, what are you guys doing with it all? Sticking under your mattress? It just is not moving. And as you can see right here, it's down. And this is quarter one. They haven't even calculated what, you know, the word I can't say, the cough. And I actually just got out of a meeting. I don't know if, for those of you that do or don't know, I'm a high school business teacher. I also teach college. And in the meeting, they're like, ooh, layoffs, and everyone starts saving your money. And the Fed's like, no, 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 move it, spend it. We can't do deflation. But I'm sorry, no matter what you do, you know, they could print infinity and beyond. It's not moving. Look at the chart. It's not moving. This is deflationary. And yes, at some point, something's going to break. Interest rates will go up, and we could go into hyperinflation. And at that point, you better understand what buying assets is, and you better buy all of them. Because the value of your money, when you stick it under that mattress, it's going away. But looking at all of these, so every time these are recessions, you see the lines go down. People stop spending money. Money stops. The velocity stops moving. And just look what is going, move my head over this way, still talk this way. We're printing like a drunken sailor, if drunken sailors can print money. But the system is breaking, clear signs. It is broken, it's breaking. And now the Fed's like, F it, we'll just buy everything. And the people aren't gonna stop them. I mean, the president. So I did a video a few back. I said, don't fight the Fed. Or end the Fed, like, don't even waste your time. Go into any Walmart, look around, because that's your average person. Look in Walmart and go, okay, so this is what we're dealing with here. And you want an uprising? You're like, no, end the Fed. No, don't, stop. Just learn the system and make money from it. And then some of you will correct me and go, Johnny Bravo, it's not money, it's actually just debt. Yes, I know. But everyone gets so confused. Okay, go make lots of debt. But in normal news today, I guess, hand sanitizer. See, this is what Walmart, this is what they watch. They're like, oh, hand sanitizer will blow up your car. It will. It's actually flammable. I don't know if you're aware of that. I live in California, and you gotta, kids that live in California, take your hand sanitizers out of the car so you don't blow the car up. And simpy stay-at-home dads are bored. They're like, I gotta do day trading, man. I'm gonna make some cash. Locked in their homes, are now obsessed with options. I haven't even touched on this channel options. I feel like I would get a complete glazed over look. And these stories would actually make me run for the hills when I see this. You know, when they're the kid, you know, they say, oh, the kid at the shoe shine is talking about trading equities. You're like, yeah, time to get out. driver turned trader, a cab driver from Arizona who has a passion for video games, just paid $4,000. Actually, hold on. This is a good picture right here. Because after a while, you option traders are going to be screaming, help, what did I just do? And yes, you can make a whole lot of money from options trading, but you can lose a whole lot more. And even his statement, this is just, it's a gamble, but a highly intellectual gamble. Okay, all right, I hear you. He said by phone, it's about knowledge and risk, but especially for guys like me, it's about sheer luck. No, it's not about luck. It's about consistent trades that you go in, you go out. And it's something that you can repeat over and over. It's not luck. You want to know what luck is? Whoever got lucky enough to get $4,100 for a course, he did a course for four. Well, my course is $190 and you get two of them? I am obviously not charging enough, but I will leave a link in the description if you would like to learn how to start a business online. I promise if I do my stock market course, I will not charge you over $4,000 for it. I'm here to help my peeps out, not, man, $4,100, put that one in your sippy cup. You don't have to suck it, just put it in the sippy cup. But like always, I tell you guys, two things. Learn how to start businesses. It could be little ones. I mean, a little bunt goes a long way, right? Playing baseball, just boop, fine, get on first. That's all we're doing, just get on first. You can even let the ball hit you in the head. Just get on first, Brian. That's why my first course was just like, here, I'll show you, buy this product, and then resell it. See, you made some money. Okay, now let's figure out how to manufacture a product and then sell that product and you'll make a whole lot more money. And please tell people in the comment section below when they're like, I don't know, I can't. I click on the link and the codes are all gone. Yes, that's because I only give a few of them. They go pretty darn fast. So if you could help me out in the comment section. Also, this is Memorial Day weekend and I will be down in San Diego or close to San Diego. My apologies if for some reason there is not a video Sunday or Monday. That is because my wife threw my phone into the ocean.